It's history tonight at Titan Stadium in Oshkosh, the first ever WIAA playoffs. Hello, everybody. I'm Bob Schultz. With me is Jim Carter. Jim, we've got two ball clubs, 1-2 in the state of Wisconsin, finally making it here. It's a big moment for these kids.
It's got to be a big moment, Bob. It's been a great season for both of them. What I like is the attitude both the coaches have taken. They feel like it's been a successful season. They both have 10-0 records. They just think it's a great learning experience for their young players to have all this pressure, have the press, the TV, and so on here. They both feel like they're winners whether they win or lose the game.
Also joining us on the sidelines tonight will be Keith Wertman. Keith, a good matchup of teams going against each other tonight.
It really is, Bob. We've got Antigo's defense, which is only giving up 5 points a game. We have Racine's offense, which is averaging 32 a game. We also have individual differences. We have Racine that's giving up, that has individual stars, and we have Antigo that is just a group defense. And I think it's going to be a really interesting game.
We'll be back for the kickoff, the Class AA championship from Oshkosh, in just a moment. With the lights of Oshkosh in the distance, we're set for the history-making moment of the first Class AA, WIAA playoff at Titan Stadium. It's a cool November night. The temperatures are in the mid-20s. Racine Horlick, number one in the state of Wisconsin, according to the Associated Press, riding an 18-game winning streak against Antigo, number two in the state. They've won 49 of their last 50 ball games, including the last 23 in a row. The toss of the coin has been won by the Rebels of Racine Horlick. They have elected to receive Dan Thorpe, number 10, is teeing the ball up at the 40-yard line for Antigo. The two deep men for Racine Horlick are number 15, Don Heinkel, and number 27, Dave Barrera. The short bouncing kick, it'll be falling on just across the 30-yard line, and Racine Horlick will put the ball in play at that point.
Bob, we'll look for that Antigo defense to go to work right away. That's the crux of their team. They've only allowed an average of 5 points a game and less than 120 yards a game. And as Keith Workman mentioned before the broadcast, there's not one standout player on this Antigo defense. It's a group effort, and they all play together, and that's the way it should be on that team defense.
Roy Whitkey, number 12, the quarterback for Racine Horlick, brings him out. He'll have Zenith driver number 21 in his backfield, along with 44, Tony Azarian, and a number 27, Dave Barrera on the wingback. The split end will be number 20, Angus McNeely. The tight end will be number 81, Ross Panic. Over the ball at center, number 53, Steve Irvine. Barrera in motion to the left. Azarian fumbles on the first play of the game.
Paul Worth, number 72, recovered the ball, a big defensive tackle, starting his first year in the varsity. Big play for Paul.
And Antigo gets the first break. It's 25 degrees, as we mentioned, at the kickoff, and I think that cold, Jim Carter, is definitely going to be a factor tonight.
Without a question, Bob. It's tough when it's cold. If your hands are cold, it's tough to handle that ball.
First and 10 from the 27-yard line. The quarterback is Dan Thorpe. Bradley, number 42, is in the backfield with him. That is Bill Eigel, number 32, carrying the ball for the Red Robins of Antigo.
Racine came out with a different look on their defense, Bob, than what we expected. They normally play a 5-2. That time they were in a 6-1 with Azarian. Tony Azarian, number 44, was back at playing the middle linebacker spot. He's the key to their defense. He's been the nose guard all year. They claim he's got 131 tackles. That's a lot of plays.
A gain of just a yard on the play down to the 26. Second down and 9. Antigo moving in Racine Horlick territory after recovering a fumble on the first play from scrimmage. Dan Thorpe kept it, had nowhere to go, and that was Pat Sura, the big defensive left end, who has 4.8 speed in the 40, who broke through to drop Dan Thorpe for a loss way back at the 31-yard line.
That's a good way to teach a team to play that option play. Go right after the quarterback and give him a shot, whether he pitches it or not, and then he'll think about it the next time.
Coach Gordy Schofield of Antigo has been saying all week that his ball club is just lucky to be in this championship. He feels that he may have had better Antigo teams in the past, those teams in 72, 73, and 75 that were ranked number one in the state.
I think Gordy likes to kid us.
He doesn't throw very often. He doesn't throw here. He is down near first down is inbound and has the first down near the 15-yard line.
Nice play by Thorpe, Bob. That puts a lot of pressure on the linebackers. When a quarterback rolls out, you have to stay in your coverage for fear that he'll throw the ball. And once he gets to the line of scrimmage, then you have to move up on him. But Thorpe's got that good running ability where he can move around, and he displayed it there in picking up the first down.
Ball is at the 15-yard line, first and 10 for the Antigo Red Robins. 9 minutes, 45 seconds to go, first period. The AA championship game, no score. A yard, and that's about it.
I would guess it's going to be a little tough for Antigo to move the ball inside, although that is their pattern, running between the tackles. As a matter of fact, we heard some folks in the broadcast booth before the game talking about Antigo just being off tackle right and off tackle left. But I think it's going to be tough to penetrate that Racine interior line. They've got some big people, and we mentioned Azarizan in there. Miskinnis, of course, and Shars, the big tackles, do a good job, as you saw in that play.
Call it no gain in the play. Second down, 15, or 10 from the 15. This is Igo up and over Houston. Number 36, the linebacker, was there to make the stop.
Hand off to Bill Igo.
Bill Igo had a big game in the victory for Antigo in the semifinals against Milwaukee Madison, as he rushed for 108 yards. He's averaged 3.6 on the year, 94 carries, 345 yards.
Houston, who made that stop, is an outstanding ball player. He's got great speed. He runs a 4.8 in the 40, which is excellent for a high school linebacker. He's an all-state candidate, bona fide.
Third down, about 8 to go for the first. Thorpe fakes and then keeps it himself, cuts back inside. Thorpe is still on his feet. He is down near first down yardage. And I don't know, Jim, he's within about a half a yard, it looks, of a first.
There again, it's that option play, Bob, and it's just what we talked about. Racine played it well the time before. This time they didn't. The defender covered the pitch man rather than go right to the quarterback, and the play there is to go after the quarterback, make him pitch the ball.
They bring the sticks out from the sideline to make the measurement, and they are shy, it looks like, about 6 inches.
It's interesting that Dan Thorpe, as you see there, they didn't make it. Thorpe, the quarterback, is the last sophomore ever to make the varsity at Antigo. 3 years ago, he's been a three-year regular. He's the youngest of five children, an outstanding football player, but that shows his ability, the only sophomore in the last few years to make that Antigo team.
Good size for a quarterback. He's 6 feet tall, 175-pound senior. Antigo and Coach Gordy Schofield, as you can tell, have decided to go for it. They really don't have anybody who kicks extra points or field goals. Thorpe can't. They go for the first here. It's Thorpe on the keeper. I believe he has the first down. The official has the foot spotted just inside the 5-yard line. First and goal, Red Robins.
Got to be the best call he can make, Bob, to have the quarterback keep the ball. There's a minimal amount of ball handling, and he's their main man anyway, so he's the key guy to go and get that first down.
The messenger guards carrying the plays in and out are 66 John Pant and number 64 Jim Graham.
That's quite a battle. 66 Pant, the left guard that plays for Antigo, going against Greg McKinnis, who weighs 262 pounds. He's got a battle tonight.
Inside, Igo stopped cold right along the line of scrimmage. No gain at all on that one, as Dave Quiroz, right side linebacker, came up to make the tackle for the Red.
No gain, it'll be second and goal. Ball is on the five.
Nope.
Sir, send us there in on that stop.
Second down, goal. Flag is down. Flags are down on the play. The ball carrier is down after about a gain of a yard, and there's a penalty indicated against Antigo.
Judging by the crowd reaction, I'd say it's a pretty partisan Antigo crowd here. A lot of snowmobile suits from that country.
I'll tell you, it's a battle, Jim, of the small town against the larger one. Antigo with a population of just 9,005. As you see, the penalty being marched off by the officials, illegal procedure. So it's the little town from up north battling the big school from Racine.
I think the little town from up north brought half their population. They claim there's going to be 4,000 people here. I believe it. From Antigo alone, that is.
The officials tonight are the referee is Dick Herrigren, the umpire Wally Hugdahl, heads lineman is Tom Spearbreaker, the field judge is Jim Ketter.
Now you see Racine's gone back to their 5-2 defense with 44 Arizona over the ball.
Pitch back. The second man threw in for the touchdown is Randy Zern, number 24, a reserve back who came in and scored the touchdown for Antigo.
Give a lot of credit to Thorpe on that. Great, great pitch by the quarterback. Racine couldn't have played it better. They came up and hit Thorpe. He had a split-second reaction and tossed the ball out there. It was a great play. Well executed.
The score coming from 10 yards out with 6 minutes and 31 seconds to play. Antigo capitalizing on the fumble turnover. Took the ball and marched it in. Randy Zern, a track star at Antigo, took it the 10 yards on the pitch out from Dan Thorpe. They'll go for the 2 points. Thorpe throwing it for the 2 points, and it is incomplete in the end zone. There's timeout with 6:31 to play in the first period of the AA championship game. The score, Antigo 6, Racine Horlick nothing. Antigo has scored first in this AA championship game. They lead 6-0, and they're kicking off to Racine Horlick. Dan Thorpe, the quarterback, also the kicker, gets a foot into this one. It's a low line drive kick. Don Heinkel goes back to the 10-yard line, has trouble finding it, and now he'll just fall down on the ball back to the 6-yard line.
I think Racine's a little shook up right now, Bob. They had a quick turnover the first time they had the ball and had trouble handling this kickoff. They need to get a few plays under their belts, get a couple first downs, and I'm sure they'll settle down.
Coached by 37-year-old Dick Wojcik, the county coach of the year. His mother and father, by the way, I believe are from Chicago originally, but they are retired now and living near Spooner, so they will see this telecast on out of Channel 13 in Eau Claire. The quarterback now is Heinkel, number 15. They switch those off. Heinkel and Whitkey. The give straight ahead for a yard or so out near the 10-yard line is Zenith Driver. And they feel, Jim Carter, that Zenith Driver is the man who will be the key to their offense tonight.
I think it will be, Bob. He wasn't even a starter last year. Came on this year and has a great year. Last week against South Milwaukee, he had 96 yards and 2 touchdowns. He's been the key to the running attack.
Caught a gain of 3 yards on the play. Second down and 7. Don Heinkel, number 15 at quarterback, calling out the signal. Driver tripped up originally behind the line of scrimmage by number 66, John Pant, made the first contact. As you take a look at number 21, Zenith Driver.
Driver brings the ball up to the 12-yard line.
Good action by Pant, the linebacker. He's one of the two linebackers stacked on the guards in the way Antigo plays their 5-2, and he reacted off the guard's block and came out to trip up Driver.
A gain of the play of 2 yards. It'll be 3rd down and 5. Driver again tries to go deep. Antigo's team defense was there to contain him. Coming up, 64, Jim Grams, and number 74, Dean Seitz.
It's interesting, Bob. The Rebels from Racine are putting a man in motion, obviously trying to get Antigo to adjust their defense, but Antigo hasn't wavered a bit. They stay right in their defensive set, just play the ball, and doing a great job of it.
Pat Sura, number 82, will punt for Racine Horlick from his own end zone. The two men who are dropping back deep are number 20, Terry Grams, and number 12, Tom Meyer. He almost got that kick block. Takes a good bounce. Antigo backs off, and they'll get the ball at about the 47-yard line of Racine Horlick. Good field position for the Red Robins of Antigo.
That's great field position for them. Again, they of course, had their first series on the turnover, and now to have the ball inside the 50, couldn't ask for much more.
Gordy Schofield, the coach at Antigo, what a record in 13 years. 105 wins, just 14 losses, and 2 ties.
You mentioned earlier Eau Claire. Does that mean all our old friends in Eau Claire are going to be seeing the broadcast?
They will see her.
All right.
Thorpe at quarterback. Terry Grams in motion to the left side. This is Igel. He gets a couple of yards, and that's all. He is stopped at the 45-yard line. Coming up was John Houston, number 36, to make the tackle. Let's set up the front line offensively for Antigo. The center is 50, Pete Solon. The guards are 66, John Pan, and 67, John Stanke. The tackles, 74, Dean Cease, and number 73, Mark Kautzka. The left end is 87, Joe Maddock. The right end, 85, John Middle. In the backfield behind Dan Thorpe are 32, Bill Eichel, 42, Pat Bradley, and number 20, Terry Graham. Graham's now slotted out to the left side. Thorpe faked it on the quarterback option and got back just about the line of scrimmage. Jim, I'm not sure whether anybody got to him or he just tripped.
I think he stumbled, Bob. It looked like a good play to start with. They had the fullback lined up tight, and it was amounted to just a counterplay. Thorpe faked to Bradley coming strong, then just took a step back and ran the ball himself. He just lost his footing. Otherwise, I think he might have had a little room.
A gain of 2 yards on the play to the 45. It'll be second down at 8. A fast first quarter, just about 2 minutes 50 seconds to go. Antigo leading in the ball game by a score of 6-0.
A ball game like this will always move fast, Bob. They don't throw the ball much. Clock doesn't stop.
It does that time because Antigo took too much time. They were having some problem, I think, in that messenger guard system and getting that play in.
Well, that's what I always said. Don't let the guards do it. You know, you have a back do that or a linebacker.
You say that with Keith Wirtgen, your old friend, down on the sideline tonight?
You're right about old friend. If he heard that, it's over.
Tom Meyer comes into the backfield for Antigo, replacing Terry Grant. Meyer's wearing number 12. Ball at the 50. It'll be third down and 13.
It's interesting. Let's see if they don't try to go to Meyer. He's the backup quarterback, but also a very versatile player for Antigo.
Thorpe going long. His man is out of bounds. That is number 12, Tom Meyer. The pass is incomplete. Down on the sidelines to Keith Wirtgen.
And people tonight should be aware of the fact that we are not going to be interviewing Antigo players because the coach says that Coach Schofield feels they will interfere with their concentration. However, the coach on the Racine side has indicated that he will allow interviews, so we will be only interviewing Racine players.
Thank you very much, Keith. Fourth down, into punt for Antigo is number 86, Mike Devine. Picks up the bad snap on the bounce and gets it off.
Good job by Devine getting that kick off. He fielded a bad snap, did a good job of blocking the ball, not unlike a catcher in baseball, got off a fine kick.
Timeout with 2:08 to play in the first period. Antigo leading 6-0. Once again, Coach Dick Wojcik of Racine Horlick has changed quarterbacks. Roy Whitkey, number 12, is back in. Dave Sura, 26, also in the backfield. Pitch back to Zenith Driver. And in there on him is number 10, Thorpe, along with number 85, John Meadow for Antigo, dropping him right about the 15-yard line after a gain of just a yard.
You've got to admire the swarming defense of Antigo. Every player we've seen so far, there's two and three players around the ball.
Second down, 9 yards to go. Racine Horlick, rated number 1 in the state by the Associated Press. 18 wins in a row. Zenith Driver, trying to go outside, looks for some room. And coming out to stop him is number 86, Mike Devine.
The trend so far is for Racine to try to run away from the monster man or the roving linebacker on the Antigo defense, who's Dave Strobel. And so far, it hasn't been too effective. We'll see if they continue on that game plan.
Ball is at the 16-yard line. Third down, 7. Less than a minute to play in period number 1. Whitkey putting it up, looking for Barrera. Runner, Dave Sura, has the completion, and he has the first down out near the 40-yard line. That's the first time that Racine Horlick has gone to the air, and they did it successfully. Whitkey is a 63% passer, 29 out of 46 on the season, 471 yards, 5 touchdowns, 1 interception. That pass to Dave Sura went for 23 yards.
That's something that Gordy Schofield was a little concerned about. He feels like Antigo isn't quite as quick or as fast as he'd like his club to be. And on the pass defense, it might cause some problems for them.
I asked him before the game how his ball club was. Tight, loose. He said small and slow.
I think Gordy tried to con us a little.
Zenith driver dragged down, and that is Dan Thorpe, number 10.
Great play by Thorpe. You can see why he's been all-conference for the last 2 years, and last year was an all-state honorable mention.
You know, Thorpe had something interesting to say during the week, Jim, about the way they feel about football in Antigo. He says, in a town like Antigo, when you walk down the street and you're a Red Robin, the kids still look up to you.
Well, that's nice to hear. That trend has seemed to change the last few years in the high school vicinities, but it's great to hear that.
A loss on the play of 3 yards, second down, 13, and that will be the end of period number one as time has run out. After one quarter of play in the WIAA AA championship, the score, the Red Robins of Antigo, 6, Racine Horlick, nothing. Along with Jim Carter, I'm Bob Schultz with the Class AA Championship. Second quarter action just getting underway. Whitkey puts it up in and out of the hands of Dave Barrera across the 40-yard line. Coming up to make the hit was number 20, Terry Graham.
Good defense again, Bob. Graham's was right there, right when the ball got to the receiver. He hit him automatically, and the ball popped out. Good defense. My old friend Charlie Hall will be home watching this, and it looks like old 44 for the Pack.
But a good hit in the defensive secondary,
you betcha.
Substitution going out of the ballgame is 27, Steve Barrera, and coming in to replace him is number 42, Tim Weber. He had a couple of older brothers, Mike and Tony Weber, who played for Coach Wojcik at Racine Horlick. Third down, 13. Fakes to driver. Whitkey puts it up. Incomplete. Intended for Tony Azarian. Over there on pass defense was the monster man, Dave Strobel, number 83.
Strobel played that ball well, but if the ball would have been a little better thrown, a little longer, Strobel played in front of the receiver, which sometimes can be a mistake. If the ball had been thrown a little longer, I believe they'd have had a completion.
Fourth down, 13. In to punt will be Pat Sura, number 82, dropping back deep. For the Antigo Red Robins will be number 20, Terry Grahams, and number 12, Tom Meyer. Good snap this time. Almost blocked that time. Let it bounce. Grahams moves out of the way in a hurry. And the kick is down to the 23-yard line. Antigo will put the ball in play there.
That surprised me a little, Bob. I thought Grahams probably should have fielded that ball. Possibly they're having problems with the lights here. I think he hindsight's always 20-20. I'm sure he feels like he could have caught it now.
I'll tell you something else that may be on Coach Gordy Schofield's mind. They fumbled the ball 11 times in this very same stadium a week ago against Milwaukee Madison. I'm sure he doesn't want them taking too many chances on loose football.
Oh, you're always on top of things, Bob. Don't miss a trick.
First down. Yards. We try. Ball is at the 24-yard line. Flag is down. Pat Bradley, the ball carrier, gets a couple of yards. We'll wait and see on the penalty.
We were looking through some records today, Bob, on what Antigo's done in the last few years. Gee, they've been number one in 72, 73, 75. They're rated number two this year. Gordy Schofield's done just a super job up there.
Illegal procedure, the penalty indicated against the Red Robins of Antigo. Moves the ball back to the 18-yard line. It'll be first and 15. You know, and he has had some truly great teams in those years, and all of those years when they were ranked number one, people in the rest of the state would say, oh, yeah, sure, Antigo, who do they play? How do we know they're really that good? That's one of the reasons it is so good, I think, to have the playoff system. Now you get to prove it.
Well, I agree with you, and the amusing part of that is Gordy tells us this isn't his best team this year when he's coming to the playoff.
That's Pat Bradley, powers the ball straight ahead for a couple of yards. Bradley is suffering from a sore leg. I don't know if that's going to affect him much tonight or not.
Coach Schofield said that they've got it well padded and they feel like he can play the full ball game. I think it's so far in this ball game, though, Bob, it's come down to the crux of what football really is all about, and it's winning with your defenses. If you don't let that other team move the ball, you can't get beat.
Antigo, as you may have heard at the top of our telecast, is allowed on defense just 5 points per game. Outside, Thorpe keeps it. He is up near the 30-yard line, and he will be still short of the first down by about 4 or 5 yards.
Interesting, that time Racine had a stunt on, which is something we haven't seen much of in the high school ranks in Wisconsin this year. They had one of their linebackers stunting with their middle guard, had him go in the opposite direction. It didn't hurt him much there because the play went outside. But that's the kind of defensive stunt that can either make you look great or it can open up a big hole and really hurt you.
Angus McNeely, one of those in on the stop for Racine Horlick. Third down, a long four for Antigo. They lead it 6-0, 9 minutes and 40 seconds to play in period number two. Thorpe pitches back. This is Randy Zern. He scored their first touchdown, and he is out near the 34-yard line. And the chains are down. We'll have to wait and see whether or not he made the necessary yardage for the first.
Big John Houston showing his versatility there again in his lateral movement, getting over to make the stop, although the first down was picked up.
The Red Robins of Antigo, while they have gone undefeated this year, Jim, have had some close calls along the way and some low-scoring ball games.
I'd sure say they have, Bob. They had ball games like this, 8-0, 6-0, 6-0, 8-3. Those are close games. Again, it comes back to that defense. Don't let that other team score much.
They are 10-0 on the season, but in five of those victories, Antigo scored but one touchdown.
They've only averaged 17 points a game, whereas Racine has averaged about 30.
That's Igel. And nowhere to go. Coming up to make the stop was number 71, the big defensive right end, Kevin Denon, a junior.
Denon's known more for his offensive ability. He's been all-conference and all-county this year, but mostly it was for his play at offensive left tackle.
A gain on the play of just about a yard. Call it second down, 9 to go. I stand corrected, a loss of a yard on the play. They get third and 11. Out of the full house backfield. Flag is down. Somebody moved early. I think everybody but Thorpe thought that snap was coming a count earlier than it did.
It sure looked that way, including the defense.
Indication illegal procedure against Antigo.
Procedure penalty against Antigo. They're not the kind of ball club that makes a lot of mistakes. That's one of the coaching philosophies, I guess you'd say, of Gordy Schofield. He thinks a team that is mentally prepared to play well does not make the kinds of mental mistakes that you just saw happen right there.
That's exactly right, Bob. As a matter of fact, a quote from Gordy this week about his Antigo team was that they'd have to play with their heads, and as a matter of fact, play over their heads to win this game.
Tom Meyer, number 12, into the backfield. Remember, he was the intended receiver on the long, lone pass that Dan Thorpe attempted in the first period. We'll see if that's the situation here as they're faced with second down at about 17. Nope, the give is to Igel. He gets just a yard or two back around the 28 or 29-yard line. Coming up to stack him up, Dave Keyrose and Angus McNeely.
Also, Pat Searle is in on that play, Bob. He's had a great year at defensive left end for Racine. He's had 100 tackles and blocked four kicks, had six sacks. That's a big year.
Two perfect teams battling for the double A championship tonight, and only one of them will have a perfect
championship.
And there were eight perfect cheerleaders there. Freaking perfect. Always like the cheerleaders. Never fail to comment on them.
Third down, 15. Thorpe is keeping it around the outside. Brought down short of the 35-yard line. Coming in to make the tackle was Tim Weber, number 42, with some help from John Houston.
Weber and Houston on that stop.
A look at the Antigo Red Robin marching band immediately beneath us in the press box here at Titan Stadium.
Trying hard to keep warm. I wouldn't want to be blowing one of those tubas tonight. It'd be awful chilly on the lips.
You may find yourself permanently attached to a tuba. The end of punt is Mike Devine, number 86.
Beautiful punt.
Booms one. Nice kick. Heinkel fields it at the 26. Across the 30, and in there to make the stop is number 73, Mark Kautze for Antigo. Timeout with 6:33 to play in the second period. The score, the Red Robins of Antigo, 6, Racine Horlick, nothing. Racine Horlick in the red uniforms, trailing in the ball game, 6-0, first and 10 from their own 33-yard line. Heinkel at quarterback. Pitches back to the deep man, number 42. Tim Weber gets a yard, maybe two, and will go down on the sidelines to Keith Wertman.
Racine tailback, Dave, Barrera seems to be the first injured player of the game. Number 27, he injured his outside of his right knee, and it looks like we have lost him for the rest of the game.
That would be a loss for them. He was on the state mile relay team for Racine Horlick, a valuable player. Alternates at the wing back spot with Tim Weber. Second down, 8 yards to go. Powering straight ahead for a couple of yards is Dave Sura.
Bob, I mentioned this earlier, and I don't mean to be redundant. Racine is trying different formations to try to offset the Antigo defense to get them to shift or to move out of their position. Thus far, it hasn't been successful at all. Antigo just hangs in there, and they each do their individual jobs, which makes that defense work.
Tony Azarian, number 44, back in the Horlick backfield, replacing Dave Sura. Azarian, the South Shore Conference back of the year for 1976. Third down, 6 yards to go. Heinkel puts it on his hip. Drag down as middle guard Roland Buck, number 60, came up to make the stop short of the first down.
You don't think the fact that Azarian's father owns a big wrecking company has anything to do with his devastating ability on wrecking offenses plays, do you, when he's on that middle guard?
Say he's a tough guy. He bench presses 320 pounds, runs a 40 in 4.5.
Well, I wish I could see some of those days.
You were never that quick, eh?
No, sir. Or that strong.
Pat Sura, sporting a 36.1-yard punting average, gets a good one off here. Meyer, a dangerous grab at the 30-yard line. He battles back to the 33. He may have misjudged that one slightly in his lights as he lunged out for it. Timeout with 4:20 to play in the first half. Antigo leading Racine Horlick, 6-0. The Red Robins of Antigo come up over the ball. They lead it 6-0 with just about 4 minutes to play in the first half. The AA championship. Give to Igel, the second man. He's out near the 35-yard line, coming up to make the tackle. Kevin Denon, number 71 for Horlick.
Hand off to Bill Igel. Igel brings the ball.
You wonder whether teams plan any special things for games like this, and I was interested to see where Gordy Schofield commented that they were going to drive down here in the same old bus they always brought, and they weren't going to stop for dinner afterward, win or lose, because we don't usually do that.
Well, I think that's good strategy, Bob. Don't change things that have been successful for you. You go with what wins.
That bus wins?
Wide open.
Look, all alone is Maddox. Joel Maddox makes the tackle, big yardage, and you don't see Thorpe put that ball up very often, and I assume that Racine Horlick defensively was aware of that. The result, a 36-yarder.
It was a good play, a little play action, and just enough to get Tim Weber, who is the defensive corner for Horlick, brought him up to the line a little bit, let the receiver get beyond him, and he have a big play completion.
First down for the Red Robins of Antigo at the 34-yard line of Racine Horlick. 3 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the first half. Antigo looking to build on a 6-0 lead. Pitch back to Igel. He goes wide. He had a good block out there from number 20, Terry Grams, that enabled him to turn the corner, and he picked up some good yardage before John Houston forced him out of bounds.
That block was the key to it, Bob. I was surprised when Igel tried to get wide, but Grams made the great block and sprung him, and he got around the corner and made some yardage.
A pickup on the play of 7 yards, down to the 27-yard line, second and three. Exactly 3 minutes showing on the clock here at Titan Stadium. Stopped as Igel went out of bounds.
Meyer in the game once more. We'll see if they go with their trend and keep trying to go to him.
The give to Bradley. Nowhere to go. It was stacked up the middle. Jim Chars and Greg Miskinis, number 78, making the stop.
Bradley, as we mentioned, does have that sore leg, but he did have almost 800 yards rushing this year. He had a 4.5-yard average, so he's had a good year.
On the play, call it no gain, perhaps a half a yard is all. It'll be third down and still 3 yards for the first. Bradley, first down.
good job. You got to credit Pete Solon, the center for Antigo there. Great block, opened up a quick hole. Good call, and kind of a surprising one. When Antigo lines up in that short, I guess we could call it a wishbone, with Bradley up so close, it's surprising they give the ball to him. But with that quick opener, quick hole, worked well.
Clock continues to tick away the seconds. We're down near 2 minutes again in high school ball. If you've not been watching us through the year and have not seen much high school ball, they normally do not give the two-minute warning. However, ironically, Racine Horlick takes timeout with 2:01 to go in the second period. The score, the Red Robins of Antigo, 6, Racine Horlick, nothing. First and 10, the Red Robins of Antigo, the Racine Horlick 23-yard line. Fort keeps it, fakes, pulls it down, and he is inside the 20, tripped up by number 71, Kevin Jennings.
Nice move by Thorpe. We've talked about him quite a bit already this ballgame, Bob, but he's the key to that Antigo team, really, offensively and defensively. Doesn't have great speed, but he's got a lot of ability and obviously a good football head. Made a nice play there.
The youngest of five children went to Badger Boys State last summer. He's interested in a career in hotel and restaurant management. You may want to hire him for Janesville.
Either that or the new one in Manitowoc. Don't forget that.
Second down, about 5, a long 5 yards to go. Gives to Bradley. He is down near the 16 or 17-yard line, just a pickup of a yard or two. And this time it's Antigo that wants the timeout. Tony Azarian coming up to make the tackle. And coming to the sideline is Dan Ford.
I think it's hard to beat this consistency, Bob. Antigo just keeps plugging at you, works hard on defense, gets the ball back for their offense. Then they just plug away at you with Thorpe running his rollouts, giving to Bradley on stuff up the middle. They're consistent. They don't make big plays, but they don't make plays that'll hurt them. Good football team.
Gordy Schofield on the sidelines talking with his quarterback, Dan Thorpe. Schofield has won or shared the Wisconsin Valley title 10 times, including the last 5.
Interesting talking to Gordy before the game, too. He doesn't have much of his voice left. I think he must have been in good voice at practice this week.
Gordy Schofield never has much of his voice left. I've followed his career up in Antigo for most of the time that I've been in television in Green Bay, and it seems every time I get around to interviewing him, a big game is coming up, and Gordy Schofield doesn't have much of that left.
Well, there's a lot of pride in this team up in Antigo. We've got some friends up there, of course, from Antigo area, and all the people there, like you mentioned earlier, not only the students, but the people in town are so proud of the team and proud of Gordy Schofield and his staff and what they've done.
Someone asked Schofield during the week if that kind of enthusiasm and response from the townspeople might get in the way, and he said, heck no. He said, I'd much rather have him be over-enthusiastic than not care at all.
No doubt about it.
Someone had suggested that they might bring busloads as many as 4,000 people down here. That would be some accomplishment if they did. That would be more, almost half the population.
Be a quiet night in the taverns up there.
Third down, 4 yards to go for a first. 1 minute and 14 seconds to play in the first half. Antigo would like to get some more points on the board. They lead it 6-0. On the end around, this is Grams, and he has nowhere to go. Big Kevin Dennett, number 71, drags him down for the loss.
Never fooled Dennett at all. He stayed right at home, played his position, was right there to make the tackle. Good open field tackle, by the way, too.
Antigo takes another timeout to stop the clock at the 1:02 mark as Thorpe comes to the near sidelines once again to talk things over. And on the far sideline, heading over there for some conversation, is left side linebacker John Houston.
I think Thorpe came over to Coach Schofield and said, well, we better try something a little different than that one. That didn't quite get it for us.
It's interesting. One of the coaches, I think from Milwaukee Madison last week, was remarking about Antigo's offense, saying, look, there's nothing to stopping Antigo. You know they got 4 plays, the fullback up the middle, the slant off tackle, the quarterback option, and the counter.
Now if you can only stop them, that's your next problem.
You got it. That time they added the wrinkle with the reverse, and we are going to see a field goal attempt by Thorpe. It will come from 37 yards away.
That's a pretty good kick here.
Keith Seidel, number 31, will hold. Kick is off to the right side, goes into the end zone. Antigo does not take advantage of the opportunity to put more points on the board. Racine Horlick will take over with just under a minute to play. The clock showing 57 seconds. Historic night for the WIAA, the first ever football playoffs. Wisconsin Interscholastic Athletic Association. Schools providing teams that participate in 12 sports for boys and 9 for girls.
It's a great thing, Bob. They tried this up in Minnesota a couple years ago and liked it so well that they had a committee meeting here in Wisconsin of coaches, athletic directors, and educators from the school itself, schools themselves, and decided they'd go with it, and I think everyone's pretty happy with it.
We may talk about some of the problems with it, and there are a few. Heichel throwing on the option. It is almost intercepted. His foot had his hands on that ball at the 35-yard line.
There's a flag down on there.
There is a flag on the
play. Heichel is down, too. It is holding, indicated, against Racine Horlick.
It's been a rough first half for Horlick.
We were talking about some of the, they did pattern this system after the one in Minnesota, and of course it's worked on a very complicated basis with computers, and you get so many points for wins that count, plus points for victories by your opponents, games that they win. One of the sad things, though, I think, is when you look at a team like Hilbert, had their first perfect season in the history of the school, and because of the way the computer worked, and it worked fairly, they are not in the playoffs.
Yeah, that is unfortunate. But I guess what it comes down to is they have to find a system that's better than any other, and this is the best one they've been able to come up with, and we all have to live with that.
None of them are perfect. Back to the 10-yard line on the penalty. Half the distance to the goal. And getting out near the 15-yard line, and that's about all, is number 15, Don Heichel. Let's go down on the sideline again to Keith Wortman.
We have Racine secondary coach Krause here. Coach, what are you going to have to do in the second half to stop their outside plays?
Well, we have to get a little tougher on the corners right now. On a couple of key plays, they've gotten they got taken in, or at least they were blocked outside enough that they couldn't get out where they belong. A little better job out of our ends. Our ends are not doing the job they're supposed to do at this time.
Thank you, Coach.
Whitkey throwing to Heichel. Played defense well out near this 18-yard line. Coming up was John Fant and Dean Cease to make the stop for Antigo.
It's interesting there, Bob. As the half ends, it was the screen was set up well, but Antigo's defense once again just keeps swarming.
The crowds cheer and the teams leave the field. It's halftime in the WIAA Class AA Football Championship. The score at the half, Antigo 6, Racine Horlick 0. It's halftime at the AA championship game with Antigo out front, 6-0. We have some statistics that may reflect the reasons for that. Total first downs in the first half for the Red Robins of Antigo, 6. For Racine Horlick, just 1 in the whole first half, 1 first down. 72 yards rushing for Antigo, 12 for Horlick. 31 yards passing for the Red Robins, 25 for Horlick. Total yardage for Antigo, 103, 37 for Racine Horlick. One score in the game. It came with 6 minutes and 31 seconds to play in the first period. And that was a 10-yard touchdown run by Randy Zern after a 5-yard penalty had pushed the Antigo Red Robins back to the 10-yard line. Zern took it in. That was the first time they got their hands on the football, and that came after a fumble on the very first play of the game by Racine Horlick. That defense of Antigo's has looked particularly tough, Jim Carter. What do you think it's going to be take Racine Horlick to bust that in the second half?
Well, I think it's going to take a little pep talk at halftime to get their spirits lifted again, Bob. I think the first half just exemplifies what we talk about the basics in football are, mistakes and defense. Now, Antigo held Racine to 37 yards total offense. That's a great first half of defense. And then that one turnover, which enabled them to get their score. So it's mistakes and defense. That's the name of the game.
I'm sure that Antigo very much would like to have had a chance to score the second time they went down there near the end of the first half. That would have been big points for them. Down the sidelines in just a moment, Keith Wortman standing along with head coach Gordy Schofield of the Antigo Red Robins. If we're set on the sidelines, let's go to Keith.
I'm standing here with Antigo head coach Gordon Schofield. Coach, did you anticipate your wide plays to go so well in the first half the way they did?
No, I didn't. We really don't have that much speed, but they're trying to shut off our off tackle so much that the outside is a little open.
Coach, you came out and you again had a long pass completed, and you're not known for your passing that much. Did you anticipate a pass in this game?
Well, it was a play-action pass in a running situation, and we caught them asleep a little bit.
One last question. What major plan, any major changes in the second half?
Just try to block somebody the second half.
There you have it from the coach that's winning.
Okay, Keith. Sounds good. Old Gordy, he's still trying to con us. He's saying he doesn't have that speed, and we got to run those wide plays. Looks awful good, Gordy. I think you're in good shape for the second half.
We'll be back for the second half of the AA championship game, Antigo, against Racine Horlick in just a moment. Titan Stadium in Oshkosh, the home field for the UW Titans from Oshkosh, and we are watching the Class AA championship game. The second half about to begin. The Rebels from Racine Horlick in the red uniforms trail in this ball game by a score of 6-0. They are the champions of the South Shore Conference. They beat South Milwaukee in the semifinals to get here, 23-14. Antigo victorious over Milwaukee Madison in the semifinals, 36-16. That's more points than Antigo has scored in any of their games all year. Steve Schoenert will be teeing the ball up. According to his coach, 90% of his kickoffs make the end zone. You're looking at him, number four. This one will not make it. It'll be fielded instead by Grahams at about the 11-yard line. He's trying to go to the right side, tries to keep his feet, goes down. Pat Sura, number 82, made the stop for Racine Horlick.
I'm sure we won't see Antigo changing much this half, Bob. They did so well the first half with their offense, had over 100 yards, most of it on the ground. I don't look for any changes at all.
They are quarterbacked by Dan Thorpe. Plays basketball, track, and baseball.
Not only that, but he plays on five different softball teams in the summer.
Does not pitch much when he's throwing a football, however. They threw only twice last week in the semifinals against Madison. He's thrown twice in the first half tonight. He keeps it himself this time. Strung out along the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play as Angus McNeely, number 20, came up to make the tackle.
All right. It looks like Racine got pumped up for that wide play. Now they had well covered. One man on the quarterback and the other on the pitch man. Had a pretty well defense that time.
Angus McNeely plans a career in medicine. He has a sister, Ann, 25 years old, who was a nurse in Minneapolis. Thorpe gives to Bradley, and he got a yard, and that's all. And it looks like Racine Horlick's defense is fired up. Dave Quiroz in on the stop, along with John Houston.
Houston's a big, good-looking prospect. Good range, good speed, great size.
Third down, 9 yards to go. Coming into the ball game is number 24, Randy Zern, replacing Bill Eigel. He's a play-in from Coach Gordy Schofield. 10 minutes, 30 seconds to play in the third period. Antigo facing a 3rd-and-9 situation. They lead in the game 6-0. Thorpe fakes the pitch out, keeps it himself. And he is down short of the first down at about the 28. Coming up to make the tackle was number 20, Angus McNeely, and 42, Tim Weber.
Somebody put a burn McNeely. He's made two great plays in his first series.
Mike Devine will be in the punt. Dropping back deep for Racine Horlick, number 15, Don Heinkel, and number 42, Tim Weber. Good kick away by Devine. That is Weber at the 35. Looking for room on the outside. He's back across the 40-yard line. Out to the 41 or 42 before he's taken down by Joe Maddock of Antigo.
That was a good-looking punt return setup. They almost had a picket fence set up, almost broke it.
9:29 to go. Timeout with Antigo leading Racine Horlick 6-0. The Rebels of Racine Horlick trying to get some offensive generated. They are at their own 41-yard line. 1st and 10. Zenith driver straight ahead picks up 4 yards to the 45, where Joe Miller makes the tackle.
Driver is going to have to spark this Racine team. He's been their big gun all year, made the big play for him. If they need to get him rolling to get back in this ballgame.
Driver, a gain of 4 yards on the play. Clock is stopped momentarily at 9:03 to go in the third period for a minor equipment repair. That's Roland Buck, who was fixing his shoe. We're set to go again. Steve Irvine brings them out at center. The guards are Jim Buble, 60, Spuckle, 66, Kevin Monahan, 54.
Once again, that unusual set.
Heinko. Powers straight ahead. He's near the first down at midfield, about a yard short.
That might have been some type of an audible at the line, Bob. The center snapped the ball. It looked like a little early. It may have just been he and the quarterback that knew what was happening.
Tony Azarian checks out. Dave Sura in at fullback for Racine Horlick. They have the ball for the first time in the second half, and they trail it 6-0 with 8 minutes and 15 seconds to play in period number 3. Zenith Driver has the first down by about a half a yard.
Hand off to Driver.
Joe Maddock is in on the tackle along with Dean Cease.
Looks like the Rebels have a little spark this half.
I was Buck on that stop. This is an official timeout for an injury.
I may be a little early. We have a player down on the field. Looks like Dave Sura, number 26. On the sideline, here again is Keith Workman.
There's been a lot of controversy over the rubber shoes versus the cleated shoes, and I have Dr. James Basilier here, who is Oshkosh North's team physician. What is your opinion on that?
There have been studies out of Philadelphia showing a significant decrease in the number of knee and ankle injuries when the soccer-style rubber shoes are used as compared to the conventional cleated football shoe.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you very much, Keith.
I'd sure have to agree with that. I think the rubber shoe will still give you the good footing, and yet it doesn't dig in and where your knees and ankles will get wrenched. I think it's a good idea. Not only that, but let's get back to this real grass. Nice stuff.
I don't know a single professional football player who likes that artificial stuff, except perhaps there might be a wide receiver or two out there.
Or a kicker. All the kickers love it.
Dave Sura, as you saw, was helped to his feet and is to the sidelines, and you also saw the first down indication. Racine Horlick is inside Antigo territory for the first time tonight. First and 10 at the Red Robin 49-yard line. Weber in motion to the right. This is Zenith Driver. And coming up to meet him is Terry Grahams, and that is the way to tackle.
It sure is. Good tackle. Looks like Driver might have been shaken up a little. I guess not. He's just, he seems to be favoring his arm or shoulder.
Terry Grahams, 5'9", 155-pound senior, coming up to make that stop from his halfback position. Gain of a yard on the play, second down and 9. This is Azarian. Roland Buck was in on the stop along with John Payant for the Red Robins. Again, on the play, just a gain of a yard.
There again, it looked like Racine was close to opening one. Mazarian tripped over his own man, actually. The hole opened up. It was a short trap play where the on guard pulled and opened up the hole, but there just wasn't quite enough room to break through.
Third down, 8 yards to go. Roy Whitkey at quarterback. He'll put it up. Throwing in and out of the hands of Weber down around the 25-yard line, and Grahams was back there on pass defense.
Too bad. It was a good pass. Just hit off Tim's hands there. There were two people open, actually. McNeely was coming across the middle, and he was also wide open.
And it brings up a fourth down situation into the ball game to punt. Will be number 82, Pat Sura, dropping back deep, where Meyer, number 12, and Grahams is number 20 for Antigo. High kick. They let it bounce, and it is down at the 22. Antigo will put the ball in play there.
The kick is down.
Timeout with 6 minutes and 16 seconds to play in the third period of the championship game. The score, Antigo 6, Racine Horlick 0.
Recovering that or downing that.
First and 10 for the Antigo Red Robins at their own 22-yard line. Flags are down. Eichel has the ball, a 3-yard gain, but there's yellow. Illegal procedure against Antigo.
So far, Bob, I'd have to say that Racine hasn't shown proof of their number one ranking. They just haven't had the spark to take off, and I think it all started early when they had the turnover in their own territory. They've shown a little bit of offensive spark now the second half, but not enough to really put points on the board.
I tell you, their coach isn't used to losing. Dick Wojcik, who played for Duffy Doherty at Michigan State, has coached football teams, wrestling teams, baseball teams, and football teams in his career, and in 15 seasons, he has never in any of those sports had a losing season.
Pretty hard to argue with that record, isn't it?
Amen. First down, 15 after the penalty. Back to the 17. Thorpe keeps it. Now throws. He's got Graham's, and it is in and out of Tim's hand, or Terry Graham's hands. And I want to tell you,
Terry Graham's hands under
the that hurts.
That's a shame. Thorpe finally found himself throwing a spiral, and he was so happy. He had a nice touch on it out there beautifully. And Grahams was a fine little football player, just couldn't hold on. That's too bad. Terry's had a great game this far. There you look at him coming off to the sideline, a little disappointed, no doubt.
Thorpe has put the ball up 3 times, completed 1 for 36 yards. The leading rusher is also Thorpe, 10 carries for 44 yards. For Racine, Whitke is 2 out of 5 for 21. Their leading rusher is Don Heinkel with 13. Zenith Driver has carried 9 times, but he's only gained 8 yards. Again, Thorpe to throw, complete to Tom Meyer, and a first down inside.
Another flag on this
territory, and we get a flag down.
Oh, that's a shame for Antigo. Good break for Racine, though.
The unhappy player is Dean Cease, number 74, throwing his arms to his sides in disgust. We'll wait and see what the call is. But obviously, it is going to negate that long pass gain and a big break for Racine Horlick.
Yeah, Cease is a little upset. He didn't feel like that was the right call. Too bad. I was just kidding about Thorpe throwing a spiral. He threw a perfect bullet that time. Couldn't throw the ball any better. I think old Gordy Schofield was kidding us about that, too. I think Thorpe's got quite an arm.
And they move it all the way back to the 17 from where the march comes, and it is going to be spotted down at the 8-yard line. We've got an ineligible receiver downfield. The indication from the official, and that hurts.
Tim Weber, the cornerback for Racine, is getting some pepping up from his teammates. I think he felt like he got beat on the corner there, and they're trying to pep his spirits up.
Thorpe. Big hole for Zern. Is he quick? Zern is still on his feet. He is across the 50-yard line and finally is dragged down by Tony Ferraro to save the touchdown.
Boy, he scooted through that hole. When it opened up, it didn't take much. He was off and running to the races. You see, the Antigo fans are a little excited up here.
Tony Ferraro saved the touchdown. The junior left side cornerback. And the big gain by Zern, who has scored the only touchdown of the game on a 10-yard run in the first period. They spot the ball down at the 48-yard line now. Another 47. Make that the 47-yard line of Racine Horlick. Distance on the run, 40 yards for Randy Zern. Pulled Antigo out of a big hole.
I think even Coach Schofield would have a hard time arguing with the speed there. Zern's got a lot of it.
Meyer in motion to the right side. Gives straight ahead for perhaps a yard, maybe two, is Eichel, or Pat Bradley, rather, number 42.
Bradley takes the ball down to the 46-yard line.
Hey, you got a guy like Eichel running at that left halfback spot who got 108 yards against Milwaukee Madison last week. You sit him down, put Zern in there for a play, and he busts one for 40.
Well, it sure doesn't hurt him any. They've got nice balance in that backfield.
Second down, 9 for a 1st. We have motion on the right side of the Antigo line. I believe that was 85, John Meadow. But the point is going toward Racine Horlick, and they may have crossed the line of scrimmage first.
I think that was the answer to it, Bob. In high school ball, of course, you can jump off, and you don't get a chance to get back. And I think the Racine defender got off first.
And the indication we have that it was Dave Quiroz who jumped offside on the play. So the ball has moved down to the 41-yard line of Racine Horlick. 4 minutes, 15 seconds to play in the third period. Antigo protecting a 6-0 lead, trying to drive for more points. Second and four. Thorpe will keep it. He's to the outside, does a good job of keeping his feet before Houston brings him down, but it's a first down for Antigo.
You wouldn't say Thorpe was a key man, would you?
Well, you know, he has carried the ball a lot this year. 84 carries, 358 yards, averaging 4.2 per carry and 4 touchdowns.
And he's already thrown more passes tonight than he usually does. He only threw 2 last week. He's already got 3 tonight.
Plus 1 that he had called back. First and 10 from the 34. This is Zern. The hole isn't there that time. The speed is, and coming up there is number 66, Jim Buckles.
Randy Zern,
Tony Ferraro, also in there for Racine Horlick.
I think Tony Azarian snuck through there across the block at the center. They've got a hand on him.
You see the time on the screen coming down to 3 minutes to play in period number 3. We've got a second down and about 8 to go for a first. The Red Robins of Antigo, 72, 73, and 75. They were the number one ranked team in the state. There were no playoffs, no way to prove that. They're number 2 ranked behind Racine Horlick this year, and it comes down to this game. We've got motion. This time it is going to go against Antigo. The guard on the right side, John Stanke, number 67, move.
This surprises me a little now, Bob. We're seeing all the penalties, the rash of penalties now here in the third quarter. This type of thing usually happens at the beginning of a ball game where everyone isn't settled. Now they should be all well settled into their hitting patterns and so on. Surprising to see all this now.
Second down, 14, and the ball is spotted back at the 38-yard line. Into the backfield is Tom Meyer, number 12, teamed up with Pat Bradley, number 42. Meyer in motion, takes to Zern. Thorpe is throwing, incomplete. Intended for number 87, Joe Maddock, and over there on pass defense was Angus McNeely, number 20.
Another nice play by McNeely. He's having a good second half.
Ball on the receive, 38.
Angus.
Good Scottish name. Clock stops with 2 minutes and 23 seconds to go. Checking into the game is Terry Grams, the star from Olcar. Up in Antigo where he works when he's not playing football. Third down, still about 14 for the first. Azarian is nose on the center. This is Zern. He's down to the 35, but that's all as Dave Quiroz, number 61, the right side linebacker, came in to make the tackle.
Quiroz on that stop.
Quiroz had quite a quote when we talked to him earlier in the week. All he had to say was, "I like to hit."
Some of the players that we asked to fill out cards about themselves provide some very interesting comments. One young man responded that, "I love women, I like co-ed gym, vanilla ice cream, and scraping the mud off my shoes."
Must have been a linebacker.
Divine gets the kick away. Good kick, bounces inside the 15-yard line, rolls down around the 10 or 11. It'll be down there. And Racine will put the ball in play. We've got timeout with a minute and 34 to play in period number 3. The AA Championship, Antigo leads it 6-0. First and 10 for the Rebels of Racine Horlick from their own 11-yard line. Whitkey pitches out to Zenith Driver. A flag is down, and so is Driver, taken down by Paul Worth, number 72, in his first year on the varsity, making the stop, but again, the yellow is down. blocking below the weight.
Can't do that. Worth looked like he used some of his wrestling techniques. He's also a varsity wrestler over at Antigo. He gave him a takedown there. 2 points. Isn't that what they get in wrestling for that?
For a takedown?
Yeah.
I don't know. You were the hockey player. You tell me.
I don't know. I got a lot of takedowns, though. A lot of two-minute penalties. I know that.
There's the indication of the penalty. Blocking below the waist.
You want to clarify that penalty for our fans?
Gordy Schofield, the head coach at Antigo, looking on from the sidelines. He had to have liked that call. Yeah, on high school ball, you're not allowed to do that. You have to hit from the waist up.
That clarifies that.
I hope it did. We got Dick Frederick, who gave us all those instructions. We better be halfway right, right?
Editorial wheeze again.
Azarian.
Roland Buck, that middle guard, making another play.
Azarian gets out to around the 9 yard. I'm surprised we haven't seen more of Azarian playing. He's their big stud. Although they Azarian figured Zenith Driver to pick up the big yardage for him. Azarian, a pretty steady performer, averaging better than 5 yards a carry.
As a matter of fact, Dick Wojcik, the coach down at Racine, said that Azarian's probably the best football player on their team this year and one of the best he's ever coached.
Gain that time of about 3 yards or four out near the 10. Pitch wide to Zenith Driver. He's out to the 14 or 15-yard line where Terry Grahams, number 20, comes up to make the stop. He gets some help from Joe Maddock, number 87.
Maddock on the stop.
There's old Gordy again
Driver
getting hoarse.
Driver brings the ball up to the 14-yard line where it'll be third and seven.
We are not a super team, he said of his team this year. I don't know. They look pretty good tonight as time runs out in period number three of the AA championship game in Oshkosh. The score is Antigo 6, Racine Horlick nothing. With Keith Wortman and Jim Carter, I'm Bob Schultz. Set for the fourth and final period of the AA championship game. Racine Horlick trailing it. And Witchie is looking for Azarian. That time the pass was behind him and incomplete. It'll bring up a fourth down.
He had a lot of pressure from Joe Matic there coming in from his defensive left end. Made it a little rough. The ball was thrown behind him mainly because of the pressure from Matic.
You mean Joe Matic from Neva, Wisconsin?
Is that what I said?
It's where he's from. Neva.
Neva. All Neva. Right, Neva.
That's quite a distance from Embarrass. I know you
know
where that
is. I know it's near Embarrass. Oh, it isn't near Embarrass.
No,
oh.
Sura. Ooh, good pressure on the kick. Fumbled by Grahams, but he picks it up at the 45-yard line, and in there quickly on him is number 42, Tim Weber.
Good field position once again for Antigo. They're on the Racine side of the 50, and it's always good to have the ball there.
The Red Robins of Antigo leading in the ball game with just a few seconds passed in the fourth period, 6-0. Antigo has gotten into Racine Horlick territory three times, scored once, and that came as the direct result or followed a turnover. Racine Horlick has crossed the 50 just one time tonight. Pat Bradley changes his mind, tries to go outside, but big Greg Muskinis, number 78, is there to make the tackle.
I see he's big. He's 6'4", 262. He's had a big year. He's an all-state candidate. Of course, his dad's a policeman down there in Racine. So maybe that's where he gets his abilities, huh?
Patrols the line of scrimmage.
I didn't want to say that. I would get a little heavy.
Okay.
We already had Azarian wrecking the offensive schemes. His dad's in the wrecking business.
Second down and 10. Cork keeps it. Gets down to the 45-yard line where he's taken down by Tony Ferraro, number 10. Tell you that Ferraro comes from an athletic family.
I'd say so. His dad played Major League Baseball. His uncle was a boxer. There's a lot of good athletes in that family.
Suppose that'll get us a free pizza at his dad's pizza place.
I rather doubt it.
10 minutes, 25 seconds as the clock continues to tick off here in the fourth period. Not a lot to smile about down in Racine at this moment, as their Rebels, the number one ranked team in the state, are trailing. Antigo 6-0. Third down, 8 yards to go. Foot, throwing long. over the arms of John Meadow, who had two men back on pass defense with him. Don Heichel was back there, and so was Ferraro. And trailing the play was Terry Grahams.
Pretty good coverage there. Wasn't much room to throw the ball. Thorpe did the right thing, throwing long, overthrowing his receiver. From my vast quarterback knowledge, I bring that on.
I see. It brings up a fourth down situation, and into punt again for Antigo is Mike Devine. Don Heinkel, number 15, and number 42, Tim Weber, are deep. Heinkel takes it at his 12-yard line, and he is taken down just across the 15 and around the 16-yard line by Dean Cease, along with some help from Tom Stanky. Timeout with 9:54 to play in the final period. Antigo leads Racine Horlick 6-0.
We're back at Titan Stadium in Oshkosh. Racine's got the ball, and back to Bob Schultz.
Oh, you did that so well. Heinkel finds out what Gordy Schofield means by team defense.
Sure was. Would you call this a seesaw battle? Is that what you term this, Bob?
I tell you, two pretty good defensive ball
players. They sure are. It's a fun game to watch from the defensive standpoint especially.
A loss of approximately 3 yards on the play. Ball is spotted down at the 14-yard line, between the 13 and 14. Don Heinkel brings him up, number 15 at quarterback. Zenith driver in the backfield along with Sura. Coming around is number 42, Tim Weber. On the end around, coming out of the wingback position.
John Meadows stayed at home, did a good job.
Some backup help from Terry Grahams as the ball has moved out to the 16-yard line. Third down and 9.
Antigo's done such a good job of putting Racine in these difficult situations. Third and long, third and 5 or 6, or in this instance, 9. It makes it tough to convert those third downs.
You see the time remaining. Less than 8.5 minutes. Heinkel, Maddock putting the pressure on. Complete to Weber. Across the 30 to the 33 or 34-yard line. Tim Weber, born on Halloween, makes the reception, and Dan Thorpe makes the tackle.
That was a nice little crossing pattern. Weber came from one side. And I didn't catch the number of the receiver coming across, but anytime in a defensive secondary like Antigo's playing there, that crossing receivers will make it difficult.
Big first down play for the Rebels. 20 yards on the pickup. First down. One touchdown and an extra point, and they're ahead in this ball game. Heinkel going long. Look out. We have an interception. Yes, we do.
Beautiful interception. Great play by Meyer.
The key interception. Tom Meyer, number 12, 6 feet tall, 150-pound senior.
He really went up and caught that ball and took it away. It was a nice play. Big play for Antigo's defense. They needed to have that ball back right now. If they can put together a couple first downs here and eat the clock, that's the clock I'm talking about, eat the clock up, it'll help them quite a bit. Put them on their way to 6-0 victory.
The Red Robins with the football, first and 10 at their own 40-yard line. 7.5 minutes to play. They lead it 6-0. Bill Eigel gets a couple of yards to the 42. Coming up to make the tackle, 61, Kiros. Bill Eigel wants to be an auto mechanic. We could use, in this world, many more good auto mechanics.
Oh, now why did you say that?
Because you haven't seen the yo-yos that have worked on my car.
Oh, now wait a minute.
Oh, I'll hear about that.
Wait till you take it in the next time. You'll meet a few of those yo-yos face to face.
Too bad about that sugar in your gas tank. Fumble by Thorpe and recovered by Greg Miskinis for Racine Horlick. And just as suddenly, the turnover is answered by Racine Horlick, and they have the football back, and Miskinis wants to make very sure he's got it. He's not about to give it up.
And that's just what we're talking about. A turnover like that can really hurt. Although the ball's almost to midfield, but it gives Racine that energy back into their offense.
Jim Buckles, number 66, made the hit that caused the fumble and the recovery by Miskinis. First down for Racine Horlick at the 41-yard line of Antigo. 6 minutes, 40 seconds to play in the game. Horlick, the number one ranked team in the state. Tony Azarian tries to find some room along the line of scrimmage and gets a yard at most.
Nowhere to go. Too many white shirts.
Thorpe and Meadow led the attack. Gain of a yard on the play, second down and nine. Gordy Schofield on the sidelines, the head coach of the Red Robins, calling out instructions to his defense. Roy Whitkey now in at quarterback for the Rebels. Zenith driver looking for room on the outside, has some, but Terry Grahams and Joe Miller, number 25, come up to make the stop.
You know, it really is interesting to me, Bob, watching this football game, and again, I'm repeating myself, but every time a tackle is made by that Antigo defense, it's not just one man. There's another and another coming to gang tackle. Sign of a great defense.
Joe Miller, one of the linebackers who was in on that stop, writes a sports column for the school paper in Antigo. Wonder where he keeps notes during the game.
Just have a good memory.
Third down, about seven to go for a first. Critical play, the pitch out wide to Weber. He is short of the first down by perhaps a yard at the 32. They had to get to the 31 for the first. It'll be fourth down and a long yard for the first.
I would guess they'll be going for this one. There's 5 minutes and 40 seconds left in the ball game. I would guess they'll have to go for it.
The play coming in from the sideline as Don Heinkel reports in, number 15. Also coming into the lineup is number 20, Angus McNeely.
Now they'll move Heinkel to the halfback and keep Whitkey at the quarterback. Have two versatile performers in the game at the same time.
And we get a whistle. Antigo wants a timeout to talk things over defensively, and will take a timeout with 5 minutes, 19 seconds to play in the championship game. Antigo leading Racine Horlick 6-0. The coaches have counseled their players. Gordy Schofield for Antigo, Dick Wojcik for Racine Horlick.
What's your prediction, Bob? Where are they going?
Azarian up the middle.
I'd have to agree with you.
Number 44, we'll see. Azarian does not have the first down. They have turned the ball over.
Big play by that Antigo defense. Swarming all over.
That could be, you know, it's funny when you look back at critical plays in a ball game, but that could have been the championship for the Red Robins.
I don't think there's any question. If Antigo can hold the ball here and not make another costly turnover, they could eat up this clock. Big play.
Tony Azarian, the man they called on, got upended along the line of scrimmage. Good defense. Dean Seast is credited with the first hit on that one. Number 74. Our thanks to our spotter, George Kurowski, and to our statistician, Bob Schultz. Bradley picks up about 3 yards out to the 35-yard line, where Angus McNeely, number 20, makes the tackle for Racine Horlick.
I think that Antigo offense can feel victory in their grasp, but looks like they surged a little more coming off the line that time. Only 4.5 minutes left in the ballgame.
Those men up front who are surging, the men you don't hear much about, the offensive line, Kautzka, Payant, Solon, Stanky, Cease, the ends, Meadow, and Maddock. Bradley again, the workhorse across the 40 and near the first down.
His leg doesn't look too sore now. I think he's feeling better.
Antigo, the little team from up north. We've got an official timeout. We'll have a measurement as they'll bring the chains in from the far sideline. I believe he's short, but we'll wait and see.
I think they are too. There's some excited Antigo fans cheering here in the cold, trying to keep warm and also back their team at the same time.
And while we were showing you pretty girls, we had the measurement, and they were about a half a yard shy of a first down.
You have to have your priorities at these ball games.
Third down, 18 inches to go for the first. Pete Sullen over the ball, the quarterback, Dan Thorpe. Will he keep it himself? Nope, the give again to Bradley. Look at this, he busts through on a play that was designed just to get the first down. He turns it into good yardage before Don Heimbo brings him down inside the 50-yard line.
Big block by Dan Rearing over on the left side. Mark Katuska, the number 73, the left tackle for Antigo. Big block, took two people.
First down for the Red Robins as the clock continues to count off the seconds. 3 minutes, 45 to go. First down at the 48-yard line of Racine Horlick. Bradley outside. Again, he picks up 4 or 5 yards. Stays in bounds, and the seconds continue to tick off. Tim Weber in there on the tackle along with Jim Buckles, number 66.
That's one of the four plays you mentioned earlier that an opposing coach said you'd have to stop, that slant off tackle. Right now, Racine is not able to stop it.
Across the way, you take a look at Coach Dick Wojcik and his staff, Dave Krause, Ken Black, John Luther, John Jacklin, Brian Kopecki, and John Lenhart, trying to figure out what they can do to stop Antigo and get the ball back, as we have less than 3 minutes now to play in the championship game. Bradley, look at this. They know where they're going with that big horse, don't they, down the stretch?
Almost another first down, awful close to it. Eating up that clock.
They have not gone to Bradley all that often tonight, but they have gone to him steadily here going down the stretch when they're looking for the big back. You know, Antigo has been known for so many years, down through the years, for always having that good big back. Boudry, who's now down at the University of Wisconsin, has been switched to a defensive end. But Antigo, through the years, has always had the big power back.
Well, Bradley sure qualifies for it.
Third down, about 2 yards to go for a first. We got motion on the left side. I think that is 73, Mark Kautzka, who moved early. Penalty will move the ball back to the 35-45 yard line, and will set up a third now and about seventh for a first down.
Kautzka's brothers played for Antigo. I don't know if you mentioned that earlier or not, Bob. He has a brother, Larry, that played in 72 and 73 on that number one team up in Antigo, and his other brother, Pete, played in 75. Good heritage of football players. You see the clock dwindling down to 2 minutes as Antigo continues to roll.
Their assistant coaches are Dale Peterson and Dennis Schmidtke. Thorpe keeps it, and he is dropped back along the line of scrimmage at the 45-yard line. Azarian was in on the stop along with Kiros.
Azarian on the stop.
And Antigo is going to have to kick the ball away on fourth down. I don't believe they would take a chance at turning the ball over with field position at the 45.
I wouldn't think so. And Racine here wisely stops the clock with 1:47 left. They want to stop the clock before the punt and have the time to work to try and get 6 or 7 points.
So we've got the timeout, and teams are at their benches. We'll take a timeout with a minute and 47 seconds to go in the ball game. Antigo leading it 6-0. The receivers are 15 Heichel and 42 Weber, awaiting the kick from Devine. He gets it away, and a good high kick. Heichel takes it at the 15, and he is scoring the ball at the 20.
And a welcome round of applause from the Antigo fans. They're excited about that play.
Dean Cease, number 74, and Gary Shattuck, number 21. In on the stop is Racine Horlick, will take over with a minute and 39 seconds, showing on the clock, and that's how much time the Rebels have to prove that they are the number one football team in the state. A look at the Antigo bench. Stanky, number 67, another fine offensive guard. Heiko puts it up. Complete on the outside to Angus McNeely, but the defense again is there. Dean Cease and Terry Grahams for the Red Robins.
I think that statement you just made, Bob, sums up the evening for Antigo. The defense is there. They've been there all night.
Ball is out to the 19-yard line. A pickup on the play of just 2 yards. Second down and 8. Just a minute to play. Heinkel rolling right, looking for room to throw. He does, and it's intercepted. Terry Grahams, number 20, has just apparently clinched the championship in double-A for the Red Robins of Antigo.
Great anticipation by Grahams. You can see him coming off the field there. He's not very happy, is he? He says, number one, I have to believe him. They're all excited, and you see Coach Gordy Schofield, he's even smiling. A lot of excitement on that Antigo bench. It's a great feeling.
To review, there has been but one score tonight. It came with 6:31 to play in the first period. Randy Zern from 10 yards out. The first time Antigo got the ball, they scored, and that has been it tonight. Seconds tick away, 40, 39, 38. Thorpe just falls down. They don't have to go anywhere with it, but can run out the clock. The officials call the time, and that will be charged against Racine Horlick, stopping the clock with 33 seconds remaining.
Look at this big crowd. There's a ton of people out here in this cold weather.
It's going to be a very pleasant drive for them back to Antigo, and a disappointing ride back for Racine Horlick. I know you said at the top of this telecast, Jim Carter, that both of these coaches were just proud and happy to have made this historic first Double-A playoff game. There's got to be some genuine disappointment going home tonight.
Oh, I'm sure there will be, Bob, but still, like we alluded to, they're both winners. They're both good football teams, well-coached, well-disciplined, and they'll come out winners, all of them, for the experience.
Ball's at the 31-yard line. 33 seconds. Thorpe will go down again. He does. 177 yards rushing tonight for Antigo, 36 yards passing.
And 6 points. They're typical. Right down the line.
That'll be the sixth game this year as the clock is stopped again as Racine Horlick exercises what I believe is its last timeout. But in five games, they have won. Coming into this one, five of their 10 games, Antigo scored but one touchdown, and they've scored one touchdown tonight, and that is apparently enough to win the state championship.
Same old thing again, Bob. We keep talking about it. Their defense won it for them. They play that swarming, aggressive defense, gang tackling, hitting hard, and keep pursuing.
An outstanding crowd here at Titan Stadium, as you mentioned, Jim. I don't think they anticipated having this many people. We don't have an official crowd count. The stadium holds, I think, 10,000. And it looks like there must be more than nine here.
I'm sure there is. This is a great crowd for a high school football game. Reminds you of Pennsylvania and Texas.
That's some of the magic and the excitement of the playoffs. Third down. Again, they go down. Thorpe just hangs on to the ball.
That should be it. Racine's out of timeouts. They can no longer stop the clock, so the clock will run out.
And we will watch and listen along with you. The new state champions from Antigo, the Red Robins, are number one. It's all over. Antigo's Red Robins, the state champions, will be back to talk to the winners in just a moment.
We would like the ball players to line up in numerical order.
You see the excitement as the Antigo players have been grabbing their coach and bringing him away. We're going to go down and talk to Gordy Scopey along with Keith Whitman. They're there on your screen now, and as soon as we can get them close enough to our camera range, we'll let you talk to them.
Turn around, Sean.
It's confusing down there. There's a lot of excitement, a lot of people moving around. We'll go to
congratulations, Keith. Coach, the first state champion. You set a precedent. Congratulations. You must be immensely proud of your men out there.
Well, we're very proud. Racine Horlick has a very fine ball club. One of the toughest defensive teams we've played against. And it's a tribute to our kids to be able to beat a fine team like that.
Coach, the score is indicative of your entire season. 6-0, 8-0, 6-0. And tonight your defense did it again.
Right. We hung in there, and that's what we've been doing all year offensively. We just don't have that outside speed. We've hurt ourselves a lot with penalties, and we did it again tonight, but we managed to hang in there with a tough defense.
That must be indicative of great coaching.
Well, I think we got some doggone good players, and I got some fine assistants.
Congratulations, Coach. You deserve it.
Thank you very much, Keith, and congratulations to Gordy Schofield. I'll tell you, Jim Carter, that when I take a look at a guy like Gordy Schofield, who labors up there in Antigo, and he turns out all those number one teams, and people keep saying, yeah, but what if you had to play the big guys all the time? I guess this is a case where Gordy Schofield showed him what he'd do if he had the chance.
Well, and I think it's interesting. I think a little bit tongue-in-cheek, Gordy told us how this probably wasn't his best team. Some of the other teams were better teams. But they came down here and showed us a great football game, and they certainly deserve to be AA champs.
Well, we, you know, this should in no way take away. I know the disappointment that has to be registered for the Rebels from Racine Horlick, but they had an outstanding season. Our congratulations to the Rebels and to their coach, Dick Wojcik. I know how disappointing it is, but there are other years, and they'll have the memory of having played in the first ever state high school football championship in Wisconsin history. For our entire technical crew tonight, we thank them for standing by and keeping somewhat warm and providing you with the pictures and the sound. To our director, producer, John Mader. For Keith Workman on the sidelines and Jim Carter, this is Bob Schultz at Titan Stadium in Oshkosh. The final score, the new WIAA state champions in high school football, Antigo 6-0 over Racine Horlick.